Good morning, Trojans. Today's date is Wednesday, November 17th, and it's a B-Day. I'm Maxwell Brown.
And I'm Erin Dinde. Our quote today is from one of America's most famous writers, Mark Twain, who had this to say about traveling, quote, "Travel is fatal to prejudice, bigotry, and narrow-mindedness," unquote. Remember that if you travel this Thanksgiving break.
Don't forget, masks are mandatory whenever you're in a building, and you are highly encouraged to wear one outside if you are not social distanced or eating. But what if your mask broke or you forgot one? No worries. You can get one from the front office or the student assistance center.
I got my mask at the attendance office.
Most teachers also have a supply of masks in their classroom. Let's take care of each other, Trojans.
This week's video from the Petaluma Wildlife Museum highlights Hamburger, the adorable three-toed box turtle.
Good job, you guys. Good job.
You got to. Hey,
I'm Chloe. I'm a senior here at Petaluma High.
Hi, I'm Ella, and I am a senior docent here at the Petaluma Wildlife Museum.
Hi, I'm Emma. I'm also a senior here.
This is Hamburger, our three-toed box turtle. Box turtles typically live over 50 years in captivity. They can get from 4 to 6 inches long as adults. Hamburger here is an adult male.
Box turtles have some unique features. One of them is that they can actually hinge their shell. So under his shell right here, which I'm going to show you real quick, there's a hinge right here. The hinge allows him to actually close up his shell, and he can protect his head that way if predators try to grab him.
Wild box turtles live in forested and meadow areas, especially in the southern United States. They are semi-aquatic, meaning they prefer to hang out in shallow water areas instead of swimming.
Hamburger gets fed 50% plant matter in the form of salad and 50% animal matter in the form of bugs. In the wild, box turtles are omnivores and can eat everything they catch.
Thanks for watching. Bye, Hamburger.
Bye.
Bye.
So hear the frogs dancing in the street. Once again, Ali will bring up the beat like this.
The Wildlife Museum is open for visitors every Saturday from 11 to 3 p.m. Go check it out.
Starting the Monday we get back from Thanksgiving break, ASB will be hosting Holiday Cheer. Holiday Cheer is an annual event where PHS students and staff collect food and grocery items to donate to families in need. This year, we are partnering with Una Vida, and we'll be collecting toiletry items such as shampoo, tampons, bar soap, and more. We will also still collect staple goods such as mac and cheese, pasta, canned goods, soup, and more. Please do not bring items that need to be refrigerated or frozen.
You'll bring the items to your second period class. And to make it more interesting, ASB will host a pizza party for the second period class that brings in the most toiletry items based on points. Each class will display a sheet that shows how many points each item is worth. So, help a Petaluma family in need and score points for your own pizza party in your second period class. December 9th will be the last day to bring items to school.
2 weeks ago, the Petaluma City Schools has invited students to represent their schools as a non-voting members on the school board. Their goal is to get a student perspective on school-related issues. 5 students at PHS are interested in the position, so all of us Trojans will be voting for one of them to represent Petaluma High School.
We have a short video from each of the candidates so you can be an informed voter. We'll bring you two of the candidates today, two more tomorrow, and the final candidate during Friday's broadcast.
What is your name and grade?
I'm Katie Hill, and I'm a junior.
Why did you become a candidate?
I became a candidate because I think it sounds super fun and interesting to sit and listen to board meetings and also be able to contribute and help be part of the big decisions that are made on the school board.
What do you think makes you better than the other candidates?
I think I'm better than the other candidates because I have a lot of experience with board positions, and I'm also just involved in a lot of sports and clubs and student advisory council, so I kind of know what school-wide issues are as well as events that are going on.
Hello, my name is Owen Evans. I want to be in the student council representative because I want to discuss ideas for the school and help make it a better place. I hope you will vote for me. Peace out.
Voting starts the week we get back from Thanksgiving break.
That's it for today's program. Stay safe out there, Trojans, and
make it a great day.